at risk on and off the battlefield. According to the CDC, the men and women who are fighting to protect our country are 60% more likely to get skin cancer than others.
But there's hope in a new less invasive treatment. ABC Action News reporter J.J. Burton spoke to the only Bay Area doctor who will soon be using that treatment and found out just how successful it's been for cancer patients in other states.
A long days with the sun beaming down is paradise for beach lovers. It's work for others like our troops. It's also dangerous for all.
The sun is a major contributing factor of all of the major skin cancers.
1.8 million Americans are diagnosed with skin cancer each year. According to the CDC, 60% are in the military, like Marine veteran Roy Breitenbach.
There was no thought that would ever be an issue. You know, you just go out and do the things that you have to do. And for me, it was, you know, almost every day, running three to five miles.
And that was his routine for years, with no issues, until 2006. He was diagnosed with basal cell carcinoma, then a few years later, squamous cell carcinoma.
I know people did have those issues. I just never thought about me getting it.
He had multiple surgeries and treatments. The cancer keeps coming back, which brings him back to Dr. Seth Foreman's office.
You will find patients that are in their 60s and 70s who have had 10 to 20 surgeries for skin cancer, and they're sick of it.
A surgery might be a thing of the past for patients like Roy. And this is a new section being added on to Dr. Foreman's office for a new treatment called superficial electron therapy. He will be the first doctor in the Bay Area to offer it.
Electrons have energy, and the energy itself is what's targeting the skin cancer, the cancer cells, and removing the skin cancer without having to actually do surgery.
According to the Moffitt Cancer Center, the treatment has a 90 to 98% cure rate.
That sounds good to me.
Dr. Foreman says he had to add this new section on because the treatment uses electrons. And patients using the treatment have to go into a room surrounded by lead.
And there they'll be shielded, their body, places that are not being treated, in order not to expose them to unneeded electron beams.
He says construction should be completed in the next few weeks, and he will start offering the treatment in June. In Tampa, J.J. Burton, ABC Action News.